Hail, O light! Hail, children of the sun! The hierarchs of the elementals gather in the sanctuary of the Holy Grail. We come to bow before the presence of the Ancient of Days, Lord Sanat Kumara. We come to manifest our Chelaship and that of every gnome and undine, sylph and fiery salamander. We would accelerate the initiation of elemental life under the Ancient of Days, and therefore we come from out of the depths of the sea. We hold the balance of the Mother Light in the astral plane, in the sea, and in the emotional bodies of the people. We are the bearers of the light in what you call the collective unconscious of the entire life wave of Earth. We are Neptune and Luara. Our twin flames span the seven seas with the light of the sevenfold Christ. Our light is the immutable light of the word that goeth forth. We are the keepers of the flame of ancient civilizations, of Lemuria, of Atlantis, and of civilizations that now exist beneath the sea and beneath the poles. We come for the salute unto the mother and her children, and to vow our vow before the light of the Holy Grail, that we will take our stand in the earth, in the water, in fire and air, to proclaim the name of the Ancient of Days and for a mighty cleansing action that shall stop short of full cataclysm, but that shall release certain discordant elements of the earth into the sacred fire by means of certain adjustments in the planetary body which are necessary to contain the light and to transmute that residual karma. Therefore, the elements are summoned. Therefore, elemental life, all beings of nature, have been alerted during this conference by the Ancient of Days, and we four who gather in the name of the four cosmic forces under whom we serve the Lamb, have increased already this day from the hour of midnight to the present the light in every elemental serving upon earth. We are grateful for the gathering of keepers of the flame quarter by quarter for this most important day of summoning the violet flame, saturating the earth with the violet flame, and therefore drawing the line of the amethyst jewel and saying to the proud wave of that human consciousness, thus far and no farther. The violet flame wall of light is as a mighty wall of the sea itself, of an oncoming wave, and that wall of light decelerates quarter by quarter at our conferences. The momentum, the gathering momentum of world discord of every kind that you also can so easily name, for that discord is all about within and without. And that which is without reflects that which is within, and that which is within is the karma that is born by the blessed undines. Billions of undines have assembled with me. They are mighty beings of great mastery, of the tides and the currents of the earth, of the flow of energy through the water and the earth, under the continents and under the seas. You would do well to attend the retreats of the mother of ancient Lemuria under the Pacific Ocean, and to learn of the undines and their tremendous facility with the energies of life. When you consider the Battle of Armageddon, it is the battle of the records and the inhabitants of the astral plane, those who have not been allowed to dwell in higher octaves or even to embody because of their perversions of the sacred fire. The undines who serve in our command have the God control of this plane, and through their blessed presence, great quantities of light and violet flame may be anchored for the cleansing of the darkness of the deep. I therefore call keepers of the flame to consider this summer as an opportunity to acquaint yourselves with the service of the elementals in the four quadrants of being, and to come to our retreats, to our abode, that we might make you greater instruments of the fire, air, water, and earth, which, of course, are the carriers of the judgment, of the karma, and of the sacred fire of the central sun. When you consider, beloved ones, that all that is released to you from your causal body or from your electronic belt registers upon your soul through one or all of the four elements, you must also realize that this energy of life passes through the very bodies and systems of the elementals. Therefore, those who serve nature and the Holy Spirit in nature with intense love will find that in this hour of transition and extremes of consciousness, that nature, the Holy Spirit, and all elemental life will turn and serve you. Blessed ones, it is expedient that a divine friendship of friends of freedom be established with the elementals. Their immense power may be called, and the great miracles of the adepts of all ages have been implemented in matter by elemental life, whereas the false gurus have imprisoned the elementals by perverted use of the mantras of God. The true gurus have employed these servants of nature for the anchoring in the matter spheres of the great light of crystal of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, observe the unascended masters, those who have the flame of God harmony, who are in tune with elemental life, have been the instruments of cataclysm that has been wrought for the judgment, or of acceleration for the bringing in of great golden ages. We have seen a great increase among our students of the acquaintance and love of sharing with the elementals. Therefore, we have come to saturate you with a water element, the element of the mother, the water of life. You well know that most of your body temple is water, and that which is not is fire, penetrating and pulsating in the center of every atom. Thus, earth and air moving in and through the most transcendent structure of matter spheres completes the cosmic manifestation fourfold of your vehicles in matter. And elemental life adorns and shares in the great beauty of your own temple and the altar therein. I have invited the Undines to bow before the altar of the heart of the messenger and the Chelas, that they might frequent your altars wherever you are in meditation. Now you have mentioned elemental life, fire, air, water, and earth in your preambles, and therefore, by that simple call, many of you have rings upon rings of elementals who gather around you, whether you are alone or together in communion. Some of you have had, unbeknownst to yourselves, 100 rings of elementals amplifying, forming a mighty echo chamber, transmitting your word to life. We come then with encouragement, for if the earth is to be saved, and saved it must be, it will be through the intercession of the sons and daughters of God, implementing the salvation of Sanat Kumara through elemental life, through the angelic hosts. Why, blessed children of the Most High, all of elemental life and the angelic kingdoms stand waiting for your call. Let there be a cleansing of the chakras and of the minds. Let hope increase, for we are here, and we love, we love, we love you and every child's heart. We love every tender grape and vine and rose and blade of grass. We love matter. We love the force field in matter of the evolution of souls. We love and we love to make you whole. Now we are very much attached to the children of the light. Therefore, we will not leave you alone. Not during this conference or ever again. Each one of you who bears the sign of Sanat Kumara as his image within your heart will have in attendance elemental life, representatives of the four cosmic forces, 24 hours a day. This is the giving to you of a veritable army of light. It is the assigning to you of troops and cosmic forces. You then, one with your Christ self in your heart, become the supreme commander, the general commanding these forces, bringing them into discipline and alignment, and sending them forth on a mighty mission of light daily. By your word, by the extension of your enlightenment and your love, these elementals will increase in attainment in your service. As you attain to greater Christ consciousness, that Christ consciousness will also infuse them and ultimately deliver to them the opportunity to rise with you in the hour of your ascension, to be given the gift of the threefold flame, to become immortal servants of the Most High under the Elohim. Therefore, the responsibility to use the elementals assigned to you to extend the flame of freedom in itself is most awesome. But when you consider that you are then to them teacher and teaching, and that as you succeed, they can inherit immortal life, you will understand that the burden of proof is upon the teacher, and all teachers who serve with the world teachers know that for every pupil who fails, they must look within to discover what is the cause. Is it not enough love, not enough forgiveness, or is it an absence of the white flame of Serapis Bay? Is it the need to draw the soul into the will of God under the Chela and the master of the will of life to be? Questions concerning the progress of Chelas are questions greatly discussed in Darjeeling and in the councils of the world teachers. Why mankind is recalcitrant, why there is division, why some have chosen the darkness and not the light. These are the questions we ponder. We have many answers. Of course, there is the seed of the wicked, fashioned out of the spiral of death in its origin. But apart from this, there are many children of the light who, for one reason or another, have left the light of their own Christ self. And though they may look into the eyes of the ascended masters or the devotees, they yet prefer the path of Maya, of glamour, of personality. The question why becomes of supreme necessity, for in studying the psychology of the people of Earth, the Great White Brotherhood evolves solutions and gives to you certain teachings. Though they may seem repetitious or irrelevant, I can assure you that these teachings have to do with the blanks and the skipped stitches of consciousness that have resulted in children of the light turning away from the Ancient of Days. Therefore, when we give our message, know, beloved, that that message is an arrow that is sent to descend upon a particular mark and vibration of consciousness, and oftentimes for a particular individual across the earth and halfway around the earth, who will ultimately receive our word in print or on tape or by your blessed conveyance of the message heart to heart. Therefore, when you look collectively at all of the dictations and teachings we have given forth, you may understand that by the process of inductive reasoning, you may search out and discover the causes behind the effect of that teaching, and you may learn that the teaching is given, my beloved, because error has crept into the consciousness of the masses of the people because of an absence of the presence of that particular teaching within your midst. We of elemental life, all who serve with us, cheer and give calls of light and gratitude for the release of the dossier on the ascension and other books of the ascended masters, for we know that the missing links will now be reset. We know that some children of the light will have a quickening and an awakening, not by a sudden burst of power, but by the mind coming into conjunction with the mind of God through the gentle cadences of the masters of wisdom and their blessed writings. We of the elementals have placed the burden upon the messenger of publishing the earlier teachings of the pearls of wisdom for this very reason. Pearl by pearl, these are the foundations of consciousness that mankind have lacked. Let these pearls of wisdom be taught to the little children in the elementary schools, for they no longer receive the foundations of the science of the pyramid of life. What is that science? It is the very delicate building in the matter spheres of the inner blueprint of spirit. And this building of the self, the citadel of the self, the vehicle of the self, as the great pyramid, has long been lost in the educational institutions of the world. And therefore, children reach adulthood, manhood, womanhood, and they have not even begun to raise up the citadel of light. I charge you, O keepers of the flame, as we keep the flame with you, distill the essence of the teaching and give it as the essential life-giving elixir of the Holy Spirit. We come, we magnify the name of the Lord, we serve, and our entrance into the physical matter spheres is to glorify the name of the Ancient of Days and to place before the people of the earth the image of the mother, the image of the children, the image of the Christ behind the form that will awaken souls to the image of their own Christ self and Sanat Kumara. In the flowing waters of God harmony, we are come. We retreat to the inner temples of Mu, and we come forth again for the keeping of the light of this conference. Ours will be a going forth and a coming in the rhythm of the currents of the earth, as the coming of the wave and the receding of the wave. So we will share in this conference and in your many projects for Saint Germain. Those who tune in to the sound of the wave will know that there is a rhythm and a cycle to life, and therefore it is essential that you ride the crest of the wave and take the tide when it comes. Feel our love and know that we are water's power in the flame of Mother to assist you always. Greetings from Aramis and Diana, Ares and Thor, and from beloved Virgo and Pelur. In the name of the eternal kingdom, come on earth as it is in heaven, Luara and I salute you.